I gripped Dad's old army compass, willing myself not to launch it at the obnoxious raven heckling me from the bedroom window. I've lived in 5 other places, but the birds in New Haven are by far the most annoying.
"Did you hear the old lady who lives here cooks raccoons and armadillos for dinner?"
the raven chirps, hopping back and forth on the windowsill. He bobs his black head at the packing boxes in my room. I know for a fact that's not true. I kick a large cardboard box labeled Nestor's comic books and dart guns under my bed. The springs under the mattress groan as the box pushes against the bed frame. My abuela is the best cook in Texas.
"Fine, don't believe me. Maybe I'll visit you in the hospital when they have to remove your small intestine after you eat too much barbecued roadkill."
I roll my eyes. Sometimes being able to speak to animals is not as cool as you would think. I clench my jaw and shove another box under my bed, getting down on my knees to push against the straining bed frame. This raven is keeping me from breaking my unpacking record. Moving among 5 army bases, I've perfected my skills. I hold the record for fastest room packing and unpacking in the entire universe. You can get away with unpacking only 1 box of clothes for about 3 weeks before your mom realizes you've been wearing your cat surfing on a piece of pizza t-shirt every day. I know sorting through your boxes in front of a curious new neighbor means he'll see all your underwear and the ratty stuff bear you still insist on sleeping with. But the secret to success is not to bother unpacking half your boxes when you get to your new location. That way, you're ready to go when your mom announces the inevitable. I wasn't surprised when mom said, "Nestor, we're moving to New Haven, Texas." We lived at Fort Hood for 6 months. I was getting used to my new school, and my classmates were about to earn friend status. My teachers finally started calling me by the right name. I knew that was my cue to get ready to move again. So 2 days ago, I set my stopwatch and timed myself as I threw my sketchbooks and pencils into 1 box, my animal encyclopedia into another, and the remaining dart guns, Legos, and Pokemon cards that had survived the last 4 moves into a 3rd box. 5 minutes and 34 seconds. Although, I forgot to pack my underwear. The raven pecks at the peeling paint on my windowsill, his thick black feathers shining in the sunlight. He looks like he's covered with oil, a twisty design of green and purple on his wings. I abandon my unpacking and grab my sketchbook so I can draw New Haven's annoying wildlife.
"Oh, so you're gonna make me famous? You even a good artist?"
The raven stretches out his feathers. I consider drawing an enormous black bear devouring the raven, feathers and bird bits flying through the air. I'm shading in just the right look of obnoxious in the raven's eye when I hear a soft knock on the bedroom door. My abuela shuffles in, her curly hair piled on her head. She tried to dye it red to cover her gray, but it's come out more of a purple. It matches the tiny flowers on her house coat. Abuela gives me a hug, and I inhale the scent of lavender. Of the 5 times I've moved, this is the first time someone I know has greeted me. Usually it's just an empty house with echoing walls and neighbors' curious eyes. I could stay in Abuela's hug forever. "And how is the unpacking?" She scans my new room and pauses when she sees the packing boxes shoved under my bed. She chuckles, giving me a wink. The raven beats his wings against the window frame.
"Oh, you are so busted."
I shake my head and look at Abuela, checking to see if she can hear my annoying animal companion too. She's busy pulling a brown paper bag from behind her back, no reaction on her face. I guess my ability to talk to animals didn't skip a generation. "Fine, I guess." I glance at the boxes in my closet shoved behind my clothes. Abuela takes my sketchbook and holds it at arm's length, admiring my raven drawing.
"Ay, mira, another masterpiece, Joselito."
Abuela likes to call me Joselito sometimes, after José Nicolás de la Escalera. He was Cuba's first painter. Abuela tells me she hopes to see my drawings one day in museums around the world, just like José's. I don't bother to tell her I don't think I'm that good. I draw because it keeps me occupied, sitting in new classrooms as the teacher drones on about equations I learned 2 schools ago. And paper and pencils are easy to pack.